What's going on, guys? It's the Rickness here, and welcome to the Ascension Olympia Challenge. Now, you might think, it's 2017, who still does zombie challenges? Well, I still do zombie challenges, and so do the three guys who I played this with, because my teammates were Sam, What the Fuck, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 0, 5, and ImCluutch. Now, what can I say about this challenge? For a start, you'll probably notice from the gameplay straight away there, my controller is a little bit glitchy. Sometimes it can be difficult for me to sprint. So, you know, sometimes I was struggling to, like, run. Like, I've shown, like, I think about a good minute and a half setup here of me getting my perks. You know, the usual challenge video format. Like, look at this. You can see on the screen here, I can't run properly. Here, it's not too bad. Like, look, you can see me, like, not sprinting at all. Because every time you pull the gun in, is the sprint stopping. But, yeah. I mean, this is going to be an interesting commentary. Because I'm going to try and talk for the entire video. Or as much of it as possible. Because the reason I'm doing this... I'm a total idiot, right? Do you know what I did? I borrowed my friend Susan's PS3. I thought, oh great, yeah, let's just get on, do a challenge. Wanted to do this Ascension challenge for so long. Wanted to do it when the whole hype of Black Ops 1 challenges were going round, and I was posting them like one or two times a week along with Black Ops 2 challenges. Before Black Ops 3 had even come out, I wanted to do this, but we never got around to it. And I actually got around to organising a team to do it with in 2017, which I think is crazy because it's hard enough for me to get a team on Black Ops 3 these days, so for me to get a team on Black Ops 1 is unbelievable. Now, hopefully these guys will be around again so we can start playing some other challenges. I think that'd be good because I want to carry on posting Black Ops 1, Black Ops 2, as well as getting into the Black Ops 3. But here we go. We're getting into the gameplay now. This is where things really started to get interesting. Round 23 is just about to begin. I might have to edit this a tad because I think I showed the waiting round or so. Oh, no, here we go. Round 23, getting started. Yeah. So the last two rounds were chaos, because I was lucky I was green player, because Sam was the white player. He had no hope, literally. I think round 23, he lost all his perks, including PhD, which was like the most important perk in this challenge, literally. Because you're on such a cramped little catwalk area, no PhD equals death, because you're using your Sally's, no PhD, there's no hope for you. But you're probably going to see here, I've only got 5,000 points. It's like, how? You're green player, you're like... meant to be the most invincible one type thing, you know, where like they go for the white, then the blue, then the yellow, then the green. People normally expect green players to have the least downs, and I did get the least downs. I'm not going to spoil anything else, but yeah, man, it was just a really good challenge. I enjoyed it anyway. But what I want to talk about today is challenges, live streaming, and just getting back involved in zombies and trying to like just have some more fun with it, because like it got to the point where no one was having fun with it. That's why I stopped uploading. That's why like all the group of like people I play with just never uploads anymore, because they don't have fun with zombies. So I'm just gonna like give it a trial run, stream some zombies over on Twitch, maybe stream to YouTube now and again, and just try and have some fun playing zombies. I want to get my friends on and just record some fun games. Hopefully that's just my computer lagging and not the actual Elgato recording, I beg. But yeah, that's the reason there's no sound, by the way. I think I might have mentioned it. I have so much stuff going on in my mind, I can't keep track. But when I set my Elgato up, I forgot to set the sound up properly. I talked about it and then I just got sidetracked. But anyway, yeah, I just want to have some more fun with zombies. Like, when we started playing challenges, like when me, did Sam, Inzi, Alec, we all started playing challenges together for the first couple of challenges. We knew how to have fun with them. We weren't taking it seriously. We weren't competitive about who got the most kills or who got the least downs or most revives. You know, we just had fun with it and we just enjoyed playing the challenges. And that's what I want to do. I want to just get my friends on and record some like live commentaries of us just pissing around on a map, you know, just having a bit of fun. Or maybe I'll stream on Twitch one night and I'll get three subscribers or followers in. Sorry, they're followers on Twitch, aren't they? Followers. I'll get three followers in and we just do a challenge just like this for fun, you know. I mean, I love it. I love the fact people want to do well in the challenges, but including myself, I'm a hypocrite for saying this because it does come towards me, because I always get really salty in challenges, and I shouldn't, because they are just meant to be fun. Like, they're meant to be challenging, but you're meant to enjoy the challenge. You know what I mean? Like, that's the whole point of doing the challenges in my eyes. It's like get away from the whole high round seriousness of like zombies and just have some fun with it. And that's what like I think people need to realize is it, at the end of the day, who cares how many downs you get in a challenge? Especially on Black Ops 1, when there's no ranking system. There's on the leaderboards, it doesn't say how many downs you got in a game. So, like, who cares, really? At the end of the day, like, people are going to watch the video. And if they actually watch the video, they'll see how hard... Like, look, Sam's down on the screen now. Now, he gets up. There's no chance for him. He's got his Sally's. He's got his Olympia. No jerk, no PhD. And that's what, like... There's no need to worry about your downs. If people watch the gameplay or enjoy or enjoy the game, they'll understand why they're going down and down and down. And it's just like, you know, there's no need to like get so worked up about it, including myself. You know, I get worked up about it. I hate going down, especially when I take a stupid down in the early rounds. You know, when like a zombie double swipes you before you got jug, or something petty like that, and then it'll put me in a bad mood, and then I'll go on to play worse during the game. Like, I'm in a bad mindset then, so then I don't play so well during the actual intense parts of the challenge. But yeah, that's what I want to talk about. That's my plan anyway. I want to get the boys who I play Black Ops 3 with on, and maybe do like an Easter egg run on every single map, just like one a weekend, and just smash one out, and I'll just upload the whole thing with live commentary and just laugh and funny moments and all that sort of stuff. And then at the end, we just sort of like do a review and just like compile all the best bits of the Easter egg runs into one sort of little video. And then I want to stream on Twitch. I want to stream most nights. I want to like just, even if like I get like 3 viewers, I just want to stream and just enjoy playing zombies. And then if people join in, and eventually we start to build a following, which is like, what, some of the best. That's how Twitch works, isn't it? But especially with the zombies community, people who get their subscribers, like their followers involved, tend to do well because they can put like zombies with followers, so then more people click, which is not a bad thing. You know, it's just clever. I don't want to say clever marketing, but it's like a clever way of getting your stream out there. And it's, I'm sure it'd be something I'd be doing as well when I get round to streaming on Twitch. But hopefully this week I can sort out my computer to allow me to stream on Twitch. I came back, like, obviously, as you know, I haven't uploaded for nearly 2 months now, and even when I did upload, it was just a FIFA video. But I came back and I just set up my OBS, and there's a little message I get like saying, oh, MSRX is not set up with this computer, please try reinstalling the program. I reinstalled the program, and then I got the message again, so I'm going to need to look into that. But basically, something about it is meaning I can't stream at 30 fps. It drops to like 21.63 frames per second, and I just streamed privately to YouTube just so I could look back at what the stream looked like, and it just wasn't good quality at all. It really didn't. It just was unwatchable, to be honest. It was like HD, but it was just laggy, if that made sense. So like the gameplay itself was actually good, but it just wasn't in like flowing, good quality motion type thing. But I need to sort that out. And if I can sort that out, hopefully I'll be streaming over on Twitch some games with like you guys. If you do want to follow me on Twitch, by the way, the link's in the description. It's just twitch.tv/RicknessLive. I think I only have about 100 followers. I used to do this a lot. I used to just stream challenges with viewers on Twitch a lot, but I used to let people, like, for example, what I used to do a lot was like say pick a wall gun on Buried, so people would say, I don't know, AK-74U or the PDW, that we'd decide on a wall gun, and then we'd all just decide on like a random place, you know, because you could draw the chalks on, couldn't you? So we just decide on a random one, and we say, okay, we're gonna whack the PDW there, get till round 10, get set up, and then just go for it there. And we just used to have fun playing with my followers. And then sometimes we mix it up and actually play other maps and just do stuff like that and just see what we could do and come up with different wargun challenges like this. And it was just like good, because otherwise we only had like 3 or 4 viewers and they were all playing the game anyway, so they weren't even watching the stream, they just had it open on their tablets and what. It was just nice because I was talking to them and they were like saying like, oh, your streams are good, and I was just like, oh, thanks, they're not as good as some streamers. Because I was just streaming through the Elgato, literally. I didn't even have OBS or XSplit, I literally had Elgato. And you know what, if you own an Elgato, you'll know there's a little streaming section. I was using that, and it wasn't great quality. I wasn't able, if I recorded, I couldn't stream in HD, and if I streamed in HD, I couldn't record in HD. But yeah, oh, here we go, shit it in the fan, Sam's getting revived, Clutch is going down. It's just like impossible as well, because when people are going down this much, they're spraying their sallies, because you've got to be covered if you're going in for a revive. You've got to shoot a few sallies when they're down, so you can revive them. And then it puts a surprisingly high drain on the Sally's ammo, so you're like rinsed out and then you have nothing left. I mean, if I was white player, I would have struggled just as much as Sam. Like, honestly, look, he has no hope here now. Look, every single one of these zombies is targeting him, and then they're going to go for what the fuck, then they're going to go for Clutch, and they're going to eventually go for me. That's just the perks of being green player. But, you know, some games you're green player, sometimes you're white. And I've had plenty of challenges where I've been white and I've just had no hope. I don't know, it's kind of a good system, but it's not at the same time. I mean, this like little system here is another example of what I was talking about. When me, like Sam, Dids, Indy and all that used to play, we all used to get, including myself again, I'm not saying I'm exempt from this, but we all used to get so salty about the colours. Like if I was white player, I'd be like, ah, oh, fucking white player, I never get the green player, it's fucking bollocks. And it just swings around with us, isn't it? Some games you get the green, sometimes you get the white, and you just gotta learn to live with that and like think, oh god, white player, you just gotta try extra hard. No, not try extra hard, but you just gotta be on the ball that you're gonna go down as I go down there. Bit of a stupid thing to do. I didn't have my Sally's out, I tried to revive with the Olympia. Probably wasn't my smartest move, but let me get back up. So now, even me as green player, I'm gonna be fucked here because I got no PhD. And yeah, we are coming towards the end of the game bit here now as it starts to lag a bit again. I think that might be the recording software, I'll have to look into that. Here we go. Right, this is where the downs start coming for me now. I take a slap there. Right, I can't speak. I spray a few in there. It's going a bit laggy, but it's alright. Down goes Sam. Here we go. Now, we're all getting breached up here. Down goes Callum. I think at this point I'm shouting like, shoot your Sally's. I go into the revive, realise Callum's got it. I jump back so I'm safe. I'm trying to cover people without like blowing myself up, and this is the end, I think, for me. Bosh, down I go. I think I have one or two more downs here, I want to say. There we go. Callum gets me up, and then there's two of them down. I don't know why I'm like talking through, you can watch this. But yeah, thank you guys for watching. I don't know why I decided to just like talk you through what's happening on the screen, like you're blind or something. You can watch the gameplay and see what's happening, but thank you guys for watching. Wow, I've talked for 11 minutes here, that's crazy. I don't think I've ever done such a long post commentary ever on my channel, but yeah, thank you guys for watching. I really did enjoy it. I just committed suicide there, I just jumped off. I thought, fuck it, it's over, I'm not ever getting to them, they've got no Sally's. Jump off, they're gonna get me. So yeah, thank you guys for watching, and hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll leave a like if you did. God, it's been so long since I've done this outro. Subscribe if you're new around here, and I'll see you in the next one. Cheerio.